lot different from the last time we flew, where this pattern was just a mess.
Trying to get over to the right a little bit more. There we go. Banner takeoff?
Yes.
See anybody? I don't see anybody.
I don't yet, but let's get up to the whole short line stop and then we'll check. All right, downwind, no one base, no one final.
I don't see anybody on our...
Look down the other end of the runway, make sure no one's landing or taking off, because that does happen. And it looks good. I don't hear anybody.
All right.
All right.
Montgomery traffic. RV702, Mike Delta, departing runway 32, runway 32, will be departing to the north, Montgomery.
All
right, here we go.
All right.
Oops, a little easier than that, Hank.
There you go. All right. And off the brakes and on the rudder. Good. Just a little bit back, a little bit back. Yep, just hold it right there. There you go. There we are. Some right rudder pressure. Yep, good.
74 is what I'm looking for.
Yes.
So we're air park exit 28 here, uniform, entering a downwind. 45 here, downwind for only 27.
Now let's crab a little bit to the right, because I feel like we're getting pushed a little bit. There you go, good.
Okay, and we're already on the heading we want, pretty much. Maybe a little bit farther right.
No, yeah, we definitely want to go towards the cement plant. So you see that red and white antenna?
Yep.
Yeah, I like to go right towards that.
Oh, okay.
Okay, and this is kind of crosswind. I would make a crosswind call and then we're departing to the northeast.
Montgomery traffic, RV702, Mike Delta's on crosswind, we're departing to the northeast. Montgomery.
What was our frequency for,
Oh, right, 13277.
Over air park, exit 382.
South 2064, proceed direct to McRae.
Potomac approach, RV702, Mike Delta, is at 2000 for 3000, 1 mile north of Gaithersburg.
702, Mike Delta, proceed on course out of the Bravo.
Proceed on course outside the Bravo, 702, Mike Delta.
There are 36 Victor, you're clear the SFRA squawk VFR frequency change approved.
Hey, 236 Victor, squawk VFR. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, today we're getting moved around a little bit more than last time.
A little bit.
Potomac Approach, Rookie 89 and 48 Charlie, I have Gettysburg in sight.
4 Charlie, stay on the coast, your line frequency change approved. November 48 Charlie, stay on the coast, your land, frequency change approved.
Okay, 3000. Overshot that just a tad. Oh, I was like, where's the red tower? Oh, we're almost up to it. That's why it's a lot lower.
Right.
Like, where'd it go? It was way over there. It's not way over there anymore. It's right here. And this tells you our actual winds up here, right?
Yes, exactly.
So it's not bad, 344 at 7 knots.
Yeah, exactly. No, it's smoothed out. The winds aloft all day have been pretty tame. But some of those surface winds earlier were
692, Roger. Visual 33 left up from the 3015. And Potomac, November 13573, checking in.
So how high would you say those clouds are?
13573, Roger. Proceed on course out of the Bravo traffic.
Well,
is about a mile northwest of your position. I'm sorry, 2 miles northwest of your position.
Broken 5,500.
2,000 feet of VFR Cherokee, descending for Gaithersburg.
And that's
looking for the traffic, 135.
That's AGL, so basically 500 feet plus that. So they're saying 6,000 indicated is where they should be.
Well, it looks like we're not that far from them.
Oh no, we're definitely below. We're definitely well.
Choose your early mile for the time.
Okay, well below 500 feet, but yeah. I'm not good at, honestly, deciphering how far above the clouds are when I fly. But no, this is definitely within VFR tolerance.
Stop 2064.
I'm just trying to get it. Learn how to gauge what would be correct. So you think that's still a couple thousand feet above?
Oh yeah, it's definitely a couple thousand feet.
Okay.
No, 13573 Chestnut Factory has gone behind you now.
Roger, 13573.
We're 20 Lima Alpha Patelli.
Oh, I see the cement plant out there now.
Yep.
I don't know if you noticed, but I moved our lesson from 4 to 3 on Wednesday.
Yeah. That sounds good.
Christian, Alaska 922, altimeter 3015, Lima current, visual 33 left.
I'm teaching at 7, so I wanted to make sure I got plenty of time to get finished.
Oh, what do you teach?
I'm an adjunct professor at UMGC. I teach cybersecurity in the graduate program.
Oh, okay.
So this is our first night of classes on Wednesday. It's online, so I just have to get to my house. I don't have to actually get out to the school.
Gotcha.
But, you know you don't want to go into another lesson without eating.
Oh, yeah. That is true.
There's a nice little bump. So the throttle actually went backwards instead of forwards this time.
It went back?
I had it at 4,900 and it actually came out a little bit.
creeped its way out.
Just a fraction. Curious, maybe we were in a little bit of a climb potentially at the time when that happened.
Oh, that's true.
Because of the way the turbulence kind of bumped us up.
Oh, yeah, all of a sudden we're at 30.
Yeah. We should probably slow down to maneuvering speed. And that's 90.
Should be 90 knots.
It is 90, yep. Yeah, I would say 4,500 should be enough.
Sure, wing 692, contact approach 125.52. Have a good day. 2, Mike Delta, you're clear the SFRA, squawk VFR, frequency change approved.
Frequency change approved, squawk VFR 702, Mike Delta.
Okay, yeah, now we can touch.
That was 1923, roger, climb, maintain 17,000.
And let's actually, let's go to Carroll, monitor them, since we're going to be out in this area.
Okay, so tell me again how I find, map.
Uh-huh.
Direct.
Uh-huh.
And then I can go recent.
Yep.
Maybe. And Carroll is there.
Still for traffic. Air 105 Delta Sierra 1800 over the downwind for 27, flying away at 27 Delta Park.
Info gives me the frequencies, right?
Yes. There we go.
So I just hit enter. Tune comm. There we go.
So that's the AWOS. Let's get the Unicom.
Montgomery
the,
traffic,
Turkey
8948 Charlie, 1-45, run midfield downwind runway 14 Montgomery.
Great. Okay, great. And if we can get the map back on, just have to hit exit. Great, thank you. And let's head towards the cement plant.
Subject traffic, jumpers way over something 13,000 below. Look out. Warrants traffic, Savage's 124 is upwind for runway 23. We're departing the pattern to the northwest. Warranted.
All right,
so altitude.
And let's actually go to 3,000.
Low approach, Bedford.
Campus traffic, Warrior 835 to hotel, final 3-4, campus.
We can do all of our climbs to full power as long as we're climbing more than 100 feet. Usually if you just have to do a 100 feet climb, just stand at what power state you're at and pitch up to about half a degree.
Last call.
Like 5 degrees or something like that. The half bar, that is, 5 degrees.
Cambridge traffic, Warrior 32097, runway heading and departing to the northwest.
Okay, so let's talk about emergencies.
Okay.
So backwards L is for most general aviation aircraft,
right.
The standard for at least a restart. And the backwards L in this pretty much goes as follows. Fuel selector is on. The
choke
is
in.
Yep. Then we go over to the ignition. Ignition A and B are both on, and the master's on. If the prop is not turning, you can try the ignition to
right.
see if POH it
does. Said it usually will not turn below 80 knots.
It will not turn below 80 knots. Okay.
Traffic, green experimental,
AX. That's pretty much it in this thing. What you do.
Turning right, Clemson, Carroll County.
Just traffic, side ventures 222, left cross.
So restart procedure is the last thing you want to do. I like to use ABC for emergencies, so that's airspeed is A, airspeed being best glide, which is 63.
Right.
So we pitch immediately for 63. If you're in cruise, most likely, very likely, you're going faster than 63.
Right.
So I know people say, as soon as you lose the engine, nose down. Well, cruise, if we're cruise, Nose down is not going to help us because we're just going to lose a bunch of altitude all of a sudden.
And gain airspeed that we don't need.
Exactly. Yep. On climb out, however, if you lose
you want to pitch down.
Absolutely. That's the very first thing you need to do.
Yep.
So we pitch for our best glide, 63 knots.
B is
best landing, so we look down below,
Ray,
down below us,
one, Delta Fox,
around us,
right downwind,
seeing if there's anything
that
will work out.
Downwind, 3-4,
and normally, you want to look for as flat as possible fields, at least that you can discern from the air.
Winchester traffic, Winchester 222.
Away from roads, because roads have power lines. Yeah, that's generally the best spots is, you know, fields. Basically, this field down here.
Yeah, there's a number of fields, and you can usually tell their road in that direction.
Yep, exactly.
So you're going to be landing with the row.
Yep, exactly.
Winchester traffic, Skyventures 222.
And then C is checklist. So at that point, if you would run whatever emergency checklist is applicable here, and or if it's just a restart, to do the backwards L, because the backwards L on a airborne engine restart is pretty much just what we just talked about.
Right, but I do the ABC first so that I've got a place to land if the restart doesn't work.
Exactly, exactly.
Because if you're like at 3,000 feet, I've got a couple of minutes.
Right, exactly.
It's not like it's going to be hitting the ground within the next 10 seconds.
Winchester traffic,
exactly.
Skyventures 222, final for 3-2, Winchester.
All right, let's make our heading directly due east.
Winchester traffic, Skyventures 311 on the go, left closed traffic.
That way we're at least out of the way, because people coming in for straight in for 2-3.
The
Frederick, they're coming in on the north, on the west side, northwest side of the cement plant. So at least be out of that way.
Winchester traffic, Skyventures 311, left crosswind, runway 32, Winchester.
Okay, go ahead and bring your engine to idle, or throttled idle, rather.
1700.
Okay, so pitch your best glide immediately.
I was trying to get through to y'all, but the guy behind
around.
Me gave me a radio check, so I assumed I was good, but I can hear you now.
Okay, so there's a road right there. There's fields all over the place. Okay.
2000 will be 45 to left downwind for 3-4.
I would probably go for that field over there, because I got enough time to go base and get there. Okay,
that sounds good.
Winchester.
Pitch up a little bit fast. You want me to start going towards it, or do you want to start?
No, yeah. I mean, do this as if it was an actual emergency.
Okay, I'm looking where it is. And so now since I've got the field established where I want to go, and I've got my airspeed pretty much where I want it to be, I can start doing a restart checklist.
Okay.
So fuel's in, choke is in, throttle is good. I go over here, my ignitions are both good. Engine's not restarting.
Okay.
Let's assume it's not spinning. I'll go ahead and try the start,
Just
to see how it spins. If it doesn't start, which it didn't, and so now we're going to start looking around and going back over to that field.
All right, very good.
Sure, kind of traffic, Skyhawk 381, Delta Fox, right downwind, runway 34, Carolina.
And let's see, winds are out of the north, so this is this would be the direction I want to land.
Yep.
Winchester.
Winchester traffic, Skyventures 311, left base, runway 32, Winchester.
And I'd actually probably have to slip to make that.
Yeah, probably.
Traffic, 4835 to the
hotel. Yeah, you can do a little bit of a slip. We're going to recover around about 1300.
Cambridge traffic.
So slips is not it's something I have not done a lot of.
Okay. So we want to do it into the wind. So left airline and then right full rudder. Yep. Right full rudder. Yep. All the way forward. Yep. There you go. Try to pitch up a little bit to slow it down. Yep, and then right full rudder. So yeah, we definitely push more rudder.
Winchester traffic, Skyventures 311 on final runway 3.
Carolina traffic, Skyhawk 381 Delta Fox, right right downwind runway 34 Carroll County.
Okay. Excellent. All right, go ahead and recover, please.
And we have positive rate of a climb.
Okay, very good. Let's go back up to 3,000. And I'd like you to, actually, let's just go to 25.
Traffic,
we're gonna, we're just gonna practice a slip again.
Okay.
This time we can do it to right aileron, left rudder.
Okay.
Yeah, the most important thing about the slip is it's full rudder. So, I mean, you just put your foot all the way down to the floor. And you just hold that in the entire time.
Okay.
And you want to keep the nose.
And you kind of control your heading with, or your track rather, with the aileron.
Exactly. Yep. And then you want to have the nose. You don't want it above the horizon, but you don't want it so low that we're gonna start speeding up a lot.
Right. You want to control your airspeed.
Exactly. So you're still pitching for your airspeed as you normally would on a landing.
I'm starting to get used to putting in right pedal whenever I hit the throttle.
Oh yeah, good.
One Delta Fox, turning right base.
I mean, is this good? Would you expect, like, is that ball good there, like that?
Oh yeah, that's perfectly where it should be.
Okay. Okay, you said 2,500, right?
Yes, please.
Oh, sorry, we're at 26.
All right. So when we do our slip, we always do our slips with an engine to idle, and then when you point downwards, I'd just like you to pick something on the ground and aim for it.
Okay.
And we'll just slip it down to 1500.
Can we go ahead and do it?
Yep.
Okay, so which way do you want to go?
Oh, we want to do right aileron, left rudder.
Traffic Warrior 02 Foxtrot, left downwind.
Oh, okay. Maybe not so aggressive.
Yeah. Okay, and I'm going towards that white house out there, which I look like I'm still going towards it.
Okay. Good. Yeah, this is good. Yeah, you have a...
So I did way too much aileron to start
way
with.
Way too much aileron, yes.
Yep. I kind of figured that out. Like, we shouldn't be doing a rollover here.
Yeah, I don't want to do that in this.
Well, you really got to push the crap out of the rudder.
Oh, yeah, you do. But yeah, you're getting like 1,250 feet a minute descent, so that's exactly what we want. Excellent.
Yeah, and I'm still look like I'm traveling right at what my target was.
Yeah.
Okay, roll out of it.
All right. Yep. Let's recover. Good. Yeah, I don't know how the steerman handles. This is definitely a very light touch.
No, the steerman's a little heavier.
Okay, that's what I thought.
And I didn't do a slip in it either.
Okay.
But the really weird thing about it is your pedals. So, you know, it's a tandem.
Sure.
Yeah, but the pedals are up against the side of the airplane. So your feet are like a good 2 feet apart.
Oh, wow, okay.
Yeah, I was like, well, that's kind of odd. Like the battery was between my feet.
Oh, wow.
Chester County traffic, citation 2010.
Because they didn't build them with batteries at the time, so.
Well, I mean, yeah, I think they did. That's how
they
started them.
Really?
Yeah.
Did they have starters?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, that plane was built in 41.
I'm thinking that Stearman is older than that, but okay.
Oh, they are. But a lot of them were built, they built them up until 1944.
Oh, I see.
Runway 34, Carroll County.
The cool thing is I realized my grandfather could theoretically have flown in that plane because he was a pilot in World War II.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And he flew the C-47,
uh-huh.
But he would have started out in something like the Stearman.
Was he in European theater?
No, he flew the CBI, China, Burma, India.
Oh,
so
okay.
Flying over the Himalayas.
Okay.
I call it the hump.
Oh, wow.
And then he was a flight instructor in Dallas towards the end of the war.
Okay.
Oh, sorry, overshot. What do you want me to do now?
All right, let's say we go over to Frederick and practice some landings there.
Okay, so let's go.
And we can probably get our turns around a point after that.
Carroll County traffic, Skyhawk 381 Delta Fox.
Reset.
Right downwind, runway 34 Carroll County.
Cambridge
Cambridge traffic, Warrior 835 to hotel, left downwind 34 Cambridge.
There we go.
There it is.
Correct?
Chester County traffic, citation.
Okay.
01 tier uniform is over Ethico inbound runway 29 full stop.
If that'll help. Oh, a little bit. Oops, I took it right off.
There we go.
Just to come to traffic, citation 2010, uniform 5 mile final, full stop.
That runway helps a little bit. Okay. Alright. Well, let's get our frequencies, check the weather, get into the tower. So we'll put in tower first.
Inbound for RNAV 01 approach.
Sorry, wrong thing.
Oh, there you go.
I was turning the wrong thing.
Warrior 02 Foxtrot departing the pattern.
And then,
Three zeros in use. Notice the airman. ILS runway 23 is out to service. Happy Zeros runway 5 is out to service. RNAV approach runway 5 is unavailable. Advise on initial contact. We have Victor. Frederick information. Victor time 1947. Winds 36005. Visibility 10. Skies 5,500 scattered. Ceiling 6,500 broken. Temperature 20. Dew point 7. Altimeter 3017. Visual approach runway 30 is in use. Notice the airman. ILS runway 23 is out to service. Pappy's and Rose runway 5 is out to service. RNAV approach runway 5 is unavailable. Advise on initial contact. We have Victor.
Frederick
Tower.
Yeah, so I pulled the throttle and pulled up to get us below 90 knots.
Oh, okay. So I thought, well, we're pitching around a lot. We should probably.
Runway 30 clear for takeoff. Northeast departure is approved.
We should probably, you know, slow down a little.
30
yep.
Clear for takeoff. 937 Sierra Alpha.
All right, so we're using runway 30.
Yep. Information Victor.
Yep, I heard that.
Most likely, they're going to give us a right base entry on 30, which is basically dead ahead. Do you see the airport?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, wonderful. That's 23 right there.
Yeah, I can see it.
Okay. All right, and we're going to be doing some pattern work.
Cardinal 19783, Shuey inbound.
And I would say I normally call them between 12 and 10 miles away.
Runway 30 or come right in.
Oh, and we are currently
12.9.
I have your request, report to 2 mile final.
So be Frederick Tower, RV 702 Mike Delta at 2,300 with,
yeah, I don't even bother with the altitude.
Oh, so just say,
and then we're coming in from the northeast.
Yeah, so we're what 12 or whatever mileage is from the northeast with information Victor to.
Oh, that's easy. It's what I looked down here, east northeast. Would tell
me. Yeah, exactly. The bottom part is where you're coming from.
Yep.
And we have information Victor, and we're doing pattern work. And let's stay here at this altitude because we don't want to be descending into pattern altitude so far out. And pattern altitude is 1300.
Right, I knew that here.
Frederick Tower, RV 702 Mike Delta is 11 miles northeast with information Victor for pattern work.
November 702, Mike Delta, Frederick Tower, report a 5 mile right base, runway 30.
Report 5 mile right base, runway 30, 702, Mike Delta.
Great.
Which basically, we just will keep this until we're at 5 miles, because we're on right base.
Yep, exactly.
And then she'll say, report 2 miles, and then she'll say,
yeah, there you go.
She'll just keep walking us in.
19783, yep. 2 mile final.
Cardinal 783, runway 23, clear to land.
Yeah, someday when they, you know, COVID-19 finally goes away, I'd like to do a tower tour.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they will definitely do that.
not so much a thing right now, but...
No, I know they're not doing them right now. Yeah. I totally understand why.
Yeah, no, it's really interesting to be up there. Get some good insights.
So this would be a challenge if I did not have sunglasses.
Oh, yeah.
I just got these. These are brand new. They're prescription, of course.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. But I made sure I got the non-polarized. Holy smokes. Okay. Airspeed had creeped up a little bit. So
yeah, mine are polarized. Sometimes I have a little trouble.
With the instruments?
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Honestly, depends on the screen. This, not so much, but...
Yeah, it is screen dependent, how the screen is made and how its display is. I was originally thinking that the trim would be, like, inconvenient, but no, it's like with your hand on the throttle, it's right there. It's very convenient. That's a lot easier than doing this.
Yes.
So we are still 3 miles to go.
Now we probably are going to have to crab to the right a little bit because we have a direct right crosswind.
And
we are just slowly getting pushed out to the left. Yeah, so you want to make, there you go.
So if I aim basically for the end of the intersection of 23 right there, that's probably about right.
Cardinal 783, taxi to park via Echo and monitor ground. Have a good one.
Cardinal 19783, via Echo, monitoring ground.
And then when do you normally start descending to pattern altitude?
Well, I figured right about the time I called him at 5 miles would be a good time.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
Frederick Towers, RV702 and Mike Delta is 5 miles right base, runway 30.
Number 2, Mike Delta, report 2 mile right base.
Report 2 mile right base, 703 Mike Delta.
Yeah, let's reduce our power to 38. There we go.
Yeah, so we're basically at the maximum crosswind component for 2-3.
Yes.
Yep. I mean, if 2-3 was our only option.
Yeah, we're at.
We're there.
Yep.
And I should be aiming at that white building.
Yeah, actually, this is perfect.
Yeah, because that should be about
where
my turning point to turn final, right? Maybe a little bit outside that?
Yeah, a little bit after that, yeah. There's a...
No, I meant as far as... My
Yep, exactly.
I'm thinking, I'm looking at the tower, actually. No, not the tower. The white building beyond the tower to the left. Oops, I'm too low. I can just hold this.
Rotary Tower 702, Mike Delta is 2 miles right base from runway 30.
Number 2 Mike Delta, runway 30, clear for the option. After your option, make right close traffic, report right midfield down.
Cleared runway 30, clear for the option. Right pattern, report midfield. 702 Mike Delta.
Tower idle. Okay, then we're going to start setting up for landing.
So go ahead and put in my
flap.
Yep,
let's get her a little bit slower below the white arc and start pitching for 65. There we go. Okay, let's make sure we're getting this down to 65. Yeah, so we have two reds, so we're going to need some power. Comes idle.
Yeah, Frederick Tower helicopter 4181 X-ray is
a little bit of a cross into the right.
To the
so
west.
Right airline
we'd like to enter the edge of the delta below
keep
1,000 feet and
yeah,
operate over towards Fort Detrick for a little while.
Speed looks good. Yep, let's work our way over center line a little bit more.
Helicopter 4181 X-ray, Frederick Tower, transition is approved. Frederick Alpha 3017, report one on station.
Okay, 3017, and we'll go. 4181 X-ray.
All right, I got the flaps. Flaps are up. Right rudder, yep, very good. Okay, good, good. Noise abatement here is we climb up to 1300 pattern altitude and then we make our turn.
Okay.
Now let's make sure we're crabbing a little bit to the right since our wind is still coming to our right. Okay. Let's get our best rate of climb, 7 VY, 74.
Oh, I just noticed the Y on there.
Oh, yes, exactly. Yep. And then you notice the A. Well, it's maneuvering speed for. I think that's for kind of a lighter load.
Oh yeah, the maneuvering speed is definitely different
based
upon the
weight.
On the weight. And since we're in a tower,
right rudder.
We don't have to.
Let's level off.
We don't have to call
X-rays on station where the
crosswind, right?
Nope, we just report where they tell us to, which was midfield.
Midfield, right.
Yeah, let's reduce power to 45.
Here for a little while.
Helicopter 81 X-ray, Roger, just advise if you'd like to do anything else.
81 X-ray, once we're done here, we're going to head over to Fort Detrick and take a look at that.
Roger.
Let's reduce the power to 4,500. There we go. That'll give us a decent speed on downwind. That's not too fast and not too slow.
Frederick Tower, RV2 Mike Delta is midfield, runway 30.
RV2 Mike Delta, runway 30, clear for the option.
Clear for the option, runway 30, RV2 Mike Delta.
Frederick Tower, 4-5-225 inbound.
So here I should throttle back.
From the west with Victor for runway 30.
Pull up to lose my airspeed.
4 flight 225 Frederick Tower, report 5 miles west for a left downwind runway 30.
5 miles west for left downwind 30, 4 flight 225.
Very good visual reference.
Tower
clearing this ridge.
Heading over
there's
to,
a cell phone tower right at the edge of it.
Helicopter 1X-ray, Roger.
That's usually where we turn.
The cell phone tower where?
We'll stay up with
in
you.
The middle of this
tree.
Oh,
yeah,
I see it. It's really hidden, isn't it?
Head
watch
back
your
over.
Speed. So a
Roger,
bit.
I guess just advise them back inbound then.
Watch your speed.
Hey, 1X-ray, thank you.
Oh. Okay, some right rudder as we get in these turns, yep. And now I'm not so low like I was last time. There we go, good. So we just keep that right crosswind in. So a little bit of right airline, a little bit of left rudder. Do a nut side slip. Yep, let's keep our right airline down. Good. Yep. Let's try to get over to the right. Yep. Oop. Okay. Yep. So no ground effect there. All right, flaps up. Yep, just careful of the pitch up attitude when you
rotate. Tower, 4 flight 225 is 5 miles.
Yeah, I brought it nose down
down
as soon as it started to come up.
4 flight 225, report left midfield downwind.
Report left midfield downwind, 4 flight 225.
So I'm not sure if your eyes transition to the end of the runway right after we cross the numbers.
Probably didn't.
Okay, because I felt like we didn't have enough time to kind of level it off smoothly again. That ground effect we kind of just brought in. Yeah, we want to try to